Hey everyone, it's Evan here from The Trade Risk on Wednesday, September 13th, here with a midweek market recap video. We're going to cover all of the major markets, the current market environment, and then finish off looking at some sector analysis. If you're new here, welcome. Thanks for watching. We do these market recap videos two times a week, Wednesdays and Fridays every single week. And we have a few trade ideas and some things, videos that get published in between. If you like the video, do subscribe to our YouTube channel. Just keeps you up to date with all of the latest videos that we put out on a week-to-week basis. So with that, let's jump into the charts here with the S&P 500. We're going to start with the SPY ETF. You can see we finished up 13 pennies here on the day, and that was good for just a marginal 5 bips higher here on Wednesday. That doesn't sound too impressive, but this week has been impressive. We saw a strong breakout to begin the week here on Monday. So if we go to that weekly chart, let's take a look at the landscape here. You can see with the weekly candle so far, which is an incomplete candle, we're midweek through, but we're up currently almost 1.5% on the week. That's good for 3.6 SPY points. And you can see we're very cleanly, clearly resolving this recent consolidation sideways to the upside, to new all-time highs. We basically have been consolidating sideways since mid to late July. So it's been a couple of months. We came all the way back down, pulled back. Well, we stalled out, I guess, right around 248 or so. We pulled back to this 242 area. It held. We rallied back up to the top end of the range, pulled off of it for a few days, and now we're sort of launching, springboarding to new highs here in the S&P 500. So if we go down to the daily time frame, basically we have a market that is now has broken out from resistance here out of a multi-week range. We're extended a bit here from the 8 and 20 period, some of these fast-moving averages, but momentum is picking up, trend is strong to the upside, breath. We saw a nice kind of surge higher in stocks making new 52-week highs this week, and other breadth metrics also kind of supporting and improving over this week's action so far. So for the three big pillars that I sort of base all of my decisions off of, trend, momentum, and breadth, everything is pointing out into the upside in the bulls' favor right now. We talked last week in our weekend video when we were back here on Friday's action, which was right in here, basically saying, look, as long as the bulls can hold us above 245, we could move sideways, maybe carve out this sideways range a bit longer, kind of similar to what we did in here in July, and then make a run for the upside. That would be some pretty healthy action. That was sort of the path that I was looking for the market to take. Clearly, the market didn't really care about spending more time moving sideways. It just launched right to the upside. In fact, this gap here on Monday, no attempt to even fill it to the downside, right? The sellers didn't even get any chance to try and come back down here or fill it in or delay this move higher. We just opened up with this gap and then continued to push higher throughout the day, got follow through yesterday, and then some more follow through continuation at these highs here on Wednesday. So lots to like right now. Are we a bit overextended? Sure. Could we pull back? Could we rest? Absolutely. But I think in terms of fighting this or in terms of direction, I think the bulls very clearly in control here across all time frames. If we started to, if you're looking at where you want to play defense or where that thought process would sort of change for me, basically three lines that are all drawn here on this chart. The first would be this 248 level. If for some reason we came crashing back down below 248, I think that would be a sign to kind of pay attention to, maybe dial back some risk against 245, 245.50 area, last week's lows. I think that's another sort of line in the sand there. Then you have the big level down here, this big area right around 243 or so, where we found multiple attempts of the market selling into it with no signs of follow through below it. So I think if you use those three points of sort of action areas in the market, I think those could be levels that you could dial back risk if we started to see this market pull back or move south. Till then, everything looks good to the upside. I think, bears might say that this market's heading higher on low volume. Be that as it may, that could certainly continue for weeks on end. That isn't necessarily a timing signal, but it is something that we could pay attention to. But For now, it's not something that is clearly that the market clearly cares about at this point. So that's the S&P 500. If we go back to the IWM, you can see this is continuing higher nicely this week as well, up over 2% so far, leaving behind last week's highs. And you can see nice kind of average volume pulling in there, getting back to the upper end of perhaps this longer channel to the upside here, starting back in December of 2016. So we look at the old highs. We're back here right around 144. We're just a couple of points away at this point. Looks like plenty of trend and momentum in favor here for the bulls supporting the IWM. And in the NASDAQ 100, you see new closing highs today, new daily closing highs today at 146.42, up just barely on the day, but again, still enough for new highs here. And it's been consolidating for basically like the S&P 500 since that mid to late July. And you can see it's just trying to grind itself higher and leave some of this old supply behind it. So lots to like there as far as the market environment goes. Let's take a look at some other major markets here. We'll start with TLT. We can see this is really isn't getting the love that the equity bulls are getting. The bond bulls are kind of in a tough spot right now. We've had a few sort of bearish developments. If we go to the weekly chart first, you can see we're down 2.1% here on the weekly chart. We do still have a rising 8 and 20 period, or a rising 20 period, a sideways 8 period, bullishly aligned though. That's you know the sort of good that the TLT bulls have going for it. But if we look here on the daily chart, what we have is this gap down that we saw on Tuesday or on Monday of this week came on some heavy volume. So you can see the uptick in volume there, heaviest volume we've seen going back a few months. We saw continuation yesterday on Tuesday. We saw more continuation on Wednesday here today. We're below this trend line. We're below this 20 period moving average. And it just really doesn't look too good here in the short term. Now, of course, that could change. We could see some stabilization. We could see dip buyers start to show up here. But as it stands right now, there are a few kind of bearish developments or change of character happening. And I think that's worth noting. I think if you're going to take a shot on the short side here, if you're going to get into TBT, short the TLT, however you want to do it, I definitely see the rationale behind that, and I do see that trend line break, and I think it's something that you could probably get into on a fairly low risk sort of way to play that downside in the TLT. So something to pay attention to, something to notice. Again, on that weekly chart, you could argue here that we're still kind of hanging up. We still want to see how the weekly candle closes. So that there's still a couple of days left to see if dip buyers want to step in here and stabilize us at these lows here back from last Friday or from two Fridays ago. But until then, I think you still need to be a little bit cautious there. So that's TLT. Going to metals next. Kind of similar situation, not as bearish, not in such a critical juncture as TLT is. GLD though is pulling back after a nice rally higher. It's been a real strong move here since basically July, so a 2-month run, and we're starting to retrace a little bit more orderly. You're not seeing a huge uptick in volume. We're kind of seeing it just sell off and pull back into the 20 period moving average. So I think that's pretty healthy there in GLD. Weekly chart, again, you can see we're pretty extended away from some of those fast moving averages. So a little bit of consolidation here, I think is still something that could be looked upon pretty healthy. And then silver, pretty much the same situation here. It's had a nice run since July. A little pullback into some of these moving averages here, I think is completely reasonable. And I think the trend can still remain higher. And, short term to intermediate term, the bulls are still very much in control there. So those are the metals. If we go to oil next, very good day here for USO, 2% to the upside. If we go to that weekly chart now, you can see starting to get back to last week's highs. We sort of talked about this sort of tough area that this was at last week on that reversal at that 20 period on the weekly chart. And you can see now the bulls have just stepped back in. We got a nice reversal here on Monday. And again, like I say, we're back to these highs here. So clearly, you have this area in here that seems to be fairly supportive here. We're seeing dip buyers really kind of step in here right around this 950 area, give or take. And I think that's a pretty good spot to measure some risk against. I think it's, again, fairly reasonable here to maybe try and do a speculative long play on USO, maybe a breakout above last week's highs for a little more conviction. But above $10 or so, I think the longer we can stay above there, the more sort of bullish or optimistic you could be there on oil on USO. Natural gas having a nice bounce back here, very similar to oil. We're already retesting last week's highs already. We saw a nice move higher on the week so far, up 5%. Very impressive move there. This is a bit of a heartbreaker for us because this was a position we had on. UNG was something we got long back here on the 21st, looking for that upside continuation. We played around in this chop, ultimately got stopped out on Friday as we made new multi-week closing lows here. This was enough of a signal in our process, the way we sort of trail up stops and manage risk, was to exit that trade there on Friday on that new closing low, and unfortunately came at the exact wrong time. We saw a nice springboard again, 5% rally back to the upside here. We got a little bit of a fade off these highs for today, so you can see maybe not the most convincing close. Maybe it needs to come back in and fill in just a bit more before this breaks out, but I still like UNG from a structural sort of bottoming play here and a potential breakout. I think if you watch the weekly close, getting above last week's highs, staying above 675, those are a couple of things that I think would be important to get us moving for a potential breakout and trend to the upside. So something to pay attention to. We are no longer in it. Took the loss in it. Something paying attention to, though, or a few of those things that we just talked about. And I think that's it. So with that, let's get into some sector analysis. Now, there is a lot that's really working here as far as sectors go. We're going to talk just about a few of them. XLE, strongest so far this week, I believe, up 2.84%, rallying right into sort of a flattening 20-period moving average, but very strong nonetheless. We talked about this in our last week video, and you can see we're already coming back up to these August highs here from just a few weeks ago. So we had this latest downdraft below all these lows. We made our push back above these lows here around from the past couple of months. We sort of talked about this analysis again in our last video or so, and we've been cruising higher since. You see a little bit of an uptick in volume here over the past several up sessions on this latest rally higher. So I do like these developments here in the energy space. I still think this is something to pay attention to, some of the underlying components here. After, you know, a reasonable rally today, I mean, maybe there's some more momentum that pushes this back up and retests the $67 level. I think you need to be, you know, pick your spots carefully, but I think this is a spot you want to, a sector of the market that you do want to pay attention to right now for the long side. IYT also very kind of sharply coming together now. It's up 1.5% this week, but you can see back to these recent highs here from earlier this year, right around March or so. We did get above them in June or July, and then we came kind of crashing back down. So we're sort of retesting back from the ups from the downside, but we do have some strong momentum here. 8 and 20 period average moving very sharply higher, supporting this move higher and showing some good momentum behind IYT. So something also to pay attention to. And even healthcare, I think, continues to work as well. New highs here, pulled back a little bit today, but again, you can see strong momentum over the past several weeks, just have been a straight line higher in the healthcare ETF. On the downside, basically utilities. We saw a strong move yesterday back to the downside here, losing 1.67% on the day. We got some more continuation today, kind of hanging out right near these lows, the lows from last week or so. We had this nice little pullback setup that got us to new highs, but very quickly rejected those highs back to these recent lows now. So I think it's something to pay attention to. We saw, again, some pretty good volume yesterday on that sell-off. So got to be a little bit careful there. It's more defensive area of the market. Stocks are at all-time highs if risk assets are really going to start to move here with some of those things like biotech, healthcare, energy. Maybe the utilities have a deeper pullback ahead of them. So XLU, IYR, kind of those, IYR. Let's see, IYR, also getting that pullback as well. So a little bit maybe more defensive in some of those or a little more caution in some of those defensive areas of the market. But if you look again at those longer term trends here in XLU, still very healthy and very much to the upside, may just have some more short term turbulence or sideways action. So that is the recap for this week, this Wednesday, the 13th. Hopefully you guys had a good day trading, good week trading so far. Thanks so much for watching, and talk to you again soon.